In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you. Because of this, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you because of your grace. Thank you because of this morning, we surrender fully and wholly unto your powerful presence, God. I will pray that Jehovah, you are going to take the preeminence of every bit of this service. Lord Almighty, we surrender that we cannot make it without you. Holy Spirit of the Most High God, you have welcome in this place today, that you may dominate every bit of our service, the praises we shall worship you with, the nature of worship we shall offer unto you. Everything, Lord Almighty, is totally surrendered unto your ever presence. Even those that shall be, they are the needs of the first service, and even the second one, we pray that Jehovah, the power of God shall be upon them, even to minister to them in total conviction, in the name of Jesus. We love you, we give you praise. Thank you even for the Sunday school. We are expecting this day of today. We declare that Jehovah, you shall be with them, with their teachers, in the name of Jesus. We love you, we worship you, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, my God and my Father, because we surrender everything unto you. In Jesus' name we pray. Tunaweza ketichi, atuta kuwa na praise. In the name of Jesus. Na nisema tutungia kwa ibada. Kwanza special kitacha Isaiah 48. Isaiah 48. Nitasoma Isaiah 48. Isaiah 48. Nitasoma 16 and 17. 48, 16, and 17. Hii kwa jene ministers, sija ingia kwa ibada ya kwanza, maana hii ministers says, is what the Lord says unto your sins. You are the King of the Holy One of Israel. I am the Lord who teaches you what is best for you, who directs you in the way you should go. I don't have to go beyond that, but it starts by 16, 16. Come near me and listen to this. From the first announcement, I have not spoken in secret. At the time it happens, I am there. And now the sovereign Lord has sent me and on me in his spirit, with his spirit. This is what the Lord says. You are the Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. I am the Lord your God who teaches you what is best for you, who directs you in the way you go. Praise the Lord. Ningetaka kuuguza kidogo niseme Mungu yule ambaye tuna mtumikia na yule ambaye tuko na yeye maisha yetu ni Mungu ambaye anataka kuhusika ili atuongoze. For guide us. God is really looking forward to guide us, not only in our lives, not only in our spiritual lives, but every bit of us. God wants us to guide us. God wants to guide us. Mungu anatamani sana vile anaweza kuwa, he is in control of your life. He is the one controlling your things, your decisions, your ambitions, your dreams. He is the one who is doing it. Na nilipokuwa nafikiria jambo hili na nikakumbuka nilifunza sana juu ya attitude. Nataka nikwambie, unajua, it is not a any time want to make many gifts or many you want to do something in life, it should not be based on how you feel good about it. It is always supposed to follow the principles of God for guidance. You must learn to obey those principles. Kuna principles za Mungu ambazo inapaswa ufuate ili ufanye jambo fulani. Hilo jambo unalofanya lisiwe lina miracle. Because many a times our plans conflict with the plans of God. Kuna wakati mwingi tutapanga mambo lakini haya mambo yana conflict na the plan and the guidance of God. So ningetakani kuambie mambo kadhaa ambayo yanaweza kukupea mwelekeo na iko katika principles of God. One, anytime you want to make any kind of a move in your life, there are ways that you should follow. One, ask about the biblical insights that you have about it. That is the one of God. Is it in the one? Is what I'm doing guided by the one of God? Whether it is the ministry, whether it is in marriage, whether it is in business, whether it is anywhere, anytime you make a decision in life, ask yourself, can this faith in the one? If they can't faith in the one, principle number one is already broken. So it's important every time, and I tell people, don't jump with one scripture. Look for insight. Insight means you go deep and deep deeper about what you are almost going to do in life. It can be dangerous if you measure with one scripture. You'll be like the Cappadocia and the Corino and the other guys that will measure on one scripture. Na wanasema usifalie kitabaa, usifalie kitabaa ukiingia kanisani na wanameja na hiyo scripture. Lakini wanakosea zingine zote nyingi. Nataka nikueleze hivyo ili you don't just do it just the way you want. Number two, you must do any consideration prayerfully. You must pray. Even before Jesus was crucified, and he knew well it was the right of, it was God's calling for him to do that. He had to pray three times. And you know about that, but he, let me always pick up a lot here, or let me move up a person here, and then I said, why did Jesus leave the apostles and down there? Na anaenda kuomba. Na anarudi tena na wakuta wamelala. Anauliza, kwa nini umelala hata saa moja? Kumaanisha Jesus pray for 1 hour, 1 hour, 1 hour, around 3 times. Na akiwa anajua vizuri Mungu amefanya hivyo. Why did he do this? He never wanted to do his will. He wanted whatever you will do, let it be aligning with God. Hallelujah. And when you hear the name of umeombea mambo fulani maishani mwako. Umechukua muda kuombea hiyo huduma. Umechukua muda kuombea maisha yako ya kawaida. Hilo ni jambo ambalo ningetaka ujue principle number two. Principle number three, seek advice from mature Christians. You know, the Bible says in the multitude of counselors, there is safety. Every time before you make steps in life, seek counsel. Many people don't seek counsel. And don't seek counsel from children. Unaweza kuuliza mtoto wa kiroho kitu amwambie, ah, hiyo unataka kufanya kwanza fanya haraka. Umechelewa. Lakini unapaswa kutafuta mtu in any area, even if it is in man, even if it is in ministry, even if it is in business, before you make final decisions, seek counsel. Don't look at something that is already prospered and you think it took 1 minute, 1 hour, 2 hours, or 2 weeks, or 2 years. It may be an empire of many years. And if you seek counsel, you may realize there has been false and appliances. If you know that, then you will make it in life. Praise the Lord. Seek advice. That is another principle that you should consider and major on. Number three. Proper assessment of circumstances. Before you make decisions in life, you must take time to assess and evaluate how able or unable you are in it. Let's go to the leader. Am I able in this? Am I going to make it? Proper assessment will enable you, as you do decisions, would you have mama? I am mama in a country of finance. It means by assessing the circumstances. Don't just do it because somebody else is doing it. Don't do it because you want just a power play. No. Show it after you have assessed and know. You must have a proper opinion of yourself. That's what you evaluate. Would you listen in either? Go away to the gentleman. Hey, you want to say? Hallelujah. Let me show you an illustration on the same. Sijui kama unakumbuka kuna wakati kulikuwa kuna wave ya Pius Muiru. Nani anajua wave ya Pius Muiru? Wakati wa maximum miracle center. Ulisikia wahubiri wakihubiri. Unasikia katika jina la Yesu. Inatenda. It was a wave. Because people never accept. And as a result of that wave, many of the violence rose up because they want to do what we were doing. And they don't know the cost of it. So they were trapped. They want to perform miracles and they have no power to perform it. Moiru employed and many people that were supposed to be praying for him. When he was doing what he was doing, but they were doing it physically. And I'm telling you the truth, many of those churches developed into serious cults. Even today, when you can go to your Kanisa, when you know how to do the Nimadevainas of Way, evaluate. Be able to evaluate, rely on people. God will notify you on things that will not make you out of progression. Now, skin of people when they are missing the identifications are quite a little double and double factor. Number five, and I think is the last one. Then I will raise my case to the ministers. In the minister's service, in the Kumanizia, you must have the inner peace. Inner peace. If there is anything that made me remain in salvation and live alone the lifestyles I had, because I was enjoying myself anyway. How about me?
Nafikiria kuwa na rasta, na nikuwa nimefuta nguai na nikiona watoto wako chini yangu niko hai. Sasa wewe, hiyo si maisha. Nilikuwa naifurahia hiyo. And I was doing it with a lot of attitude. Kwanza nikikwimba nilikuwa nalala barabarani katikati. Hiyo ni I was enjoying it. Na hakuna mtu angeniguza. But when I was at the max, nilipokumbana na mama, nilipokumbana na mama mzee, nikikumbana na mzee mkubwa kuliko mimi, asubuhi ndio nilikuwa sina amani. Na kujua kuna kitu nilifanya. Ikiwa on my eyes. Sasa nimerudi on my normal. Ama on my rules. Hapo ndipo nasikia amani ya lakini sikize, wakati nilipokea Yesu, hata nikuwa sina pesa kwa mfuko, nina amani, nasikia kia amani fulani. Hiyo amani ndio ilinifanya niendelee kwa hiyo wokovu. Nilipooa, mimi nakuambia, nilipofikiria kuoa, unajua si wakati wa kuoa sasa, nilipofikiria kuoa last time. One thing that made me continue in it was the peace. Unajua nikuambie, ukipata hata ni boyfriend wa aina gani, hata awe anatembea na mandhara na maliko na mbwembwe, tafadhali, ukiwa ukienda ukimalizana mkitembea all those things ukimaliza tu usikii ukiwa na amani, ajili mwisho utakuwa na shida kubwa sana ukiendelea. Hata ikiwa ni kisafari na ulikuwa umeamua kuamka asubuhi kwenda na usikii amani imeisha, usiende, kuna uwezekano kuwe na ajali mbele. Uliza mwenzako, uko na amani kwa hayo maisha yako? Hizo decisions uko na amani? Kwa hiyo huduma uko na amani? Bwana asifiwe. Kwa hiyo biashara ukienda uko ndani uko umeketi huko hata kwa utauza hiyo siku uko na amani? Ukiwa unauza ama unauza uko na amani? How many people know that Indians don't flourish because they sell too much? They do what they do not because they do it for profit. They do it as a lifestyle. Ndiyo maana mwingi anaweza kwenda keti pale mununue ama mkataki fanya nini? Ana shughuli, utaona akitembea tembea hapo, atawaambia saa saba muondoke mwende. Si ataona masaa ati hii masaa mnamwingia, atawaambia saa saba ikifika hii ondokeni mkakule. Mkirudi jioni, mkirudi saa saba saa nane, unakuta kuna duka vitu sadaka. Ameachwa yeye amekula huko ndani, alafu akaanza kuabudu miungu. Baadaye ukimaliza hata siku ukiamka, ukienda kazi anamwambia kaende huko nje. Anafanya miungu yake kafara. Kwa sababu gani? Yeye ndiye anafanya biashara akipata profit sana. Ni lifestyle yake. Na nikwambie, that is the thing I want you to have. At your peace. Even when you have done nothing, you have not accomplished a lot of things, but you are at peace. You may not be driving a very big car, but you are at peace. You don't have a lot of money, but you are at peace. Kuna watu wako na pesa na hawalali. You are not married, but you are not desperate. You are at peace. That inner peace is what gives you the power to make more decisions in life. If you have no peace, leave it. Drop it like a crossing. Hata kwa ndoa usiwaita ukua una amani. Ni yeye mtoke hata ukua nusu. Hivyo ndivyo naambia kwa kuliko ukuvia hapo kuli. Sema amen. Na usiseme amen ukua unalala kwa kwa. Bwana asifiwe. Halo. Hata huduma kama hii, ukiingia kanisa kama hii usikia una amani. Kuna mtu mmoja tulikutana naye akaniambia, mimi nikiingia kwa hiyo kanisa, ninasikia niko amaniless. Nikamwambia, "Oh, tafuta ile utakuwa na amani." Na ni hivyo, na hakuna kitu kingine. Na ni vizuri uwe na amani.
in anything. Praise the Lord.
What does it do? So when God gives direction, according to Isaiah 48, 16, and 17, then the heavy result is you are supposed to have peace in your heart. God bless you in Jesus' name. Let's go to the first service. First service.